बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। ऑक्यूपेशनल हेल्थ, ऑक्यूपेशनल हेल्थ इज एसेंशियली प्रिवेंटिव और सोशल मेडिसिन। द जॉइंट आईएलओ WHO कमेटी ऑन ऑक्यूपेशनल हेल्थ इन द कोर्स ऑफ इट्स फर्स्ट सेशन हेल्ड इन 1950 गेव द फॉलोइंग डेफिनेशन। Occupational health should aim at the promotion and maintenance of the highest degree of the physical, mental and social well-being of workers in all occupations. The prevention among workers of departures from health caused by their working conditions, the protections of workers in their employment from risk resulting from factors adverse to health, the placing and maintenance of the worker is an occupational environment adapted to his physiological and psychological equipment, and to summarize the preventive adaptation of work to a man and for each man to his job. This is the little bit history, and this is the goal: first, to reduce industrial accidents, to prevent occupational hazards / diseases, to achieve maximum human efficiency and machine efficiency, and to reduce sick absenteeism. These are the goals and the objectives of occupational health. Number one, to maintain and promote the physical, mental and social well-being of the worker. Two, to prevent occupational diseases and injuries. Three, to adapt the workplace and work environment to the needs of the workers. That is application of agronomics principle. It should be preventive rather than curative. Occupational health have the same aim: the prevention of disease and maintenance of the highest degree of physical, mental and social well-being of workers in all occupation. The level of applications of preventive measures are the same: health promotion, specific protection, early diagnosis and treatment, disability limitation and rehabilitation. The tools are the same: epidemiologic approach, statistic, health screening, health education, etc. Health, occupational health, therefore, is the application of preventive medicine in all the places of employment. In the past, it was the customary to think of occupational health entirely in relation to factories and mines. Hence, the term industrial hygiene or industrial health were in vogue. Modern concept of occupational health now embrace all types of employment, including mercantile and commercial enterprises, services, trades, forestry and agriculture, and includes the subject of industrial hygiene. Industrial diseases, industrial accidents, toxicology in relation to industrial hazards, hazards rehabilitation and occupational psychology, occupational health in agriculture and agronomics, it's called simply human engineering, are relatively new concepts. Ergonomics is also a well-known recognized discipline and constitutes an integral part of any advanced occupational health services. The term ergonomics is derived from the Greek ergon, meaning work, and norms, meaning law. It simply means fitting the job to the worker. Training in ergonomics involves designing of machines, tools, equipment and manufacturing process, layout of the places of work, methods of work and environment in order to achieve greater efficiency both in man and machine. The objective of ergonomics is is to achieve the best mutual adjustment of man and his work for the improvement of human efficiency and well-being, the application of ergonomics has made a significant contribution to reducing industrial accidents and to the overall health and efficiency to the workers. Health, what is occupational health care? This is a question in every person's mind. Health care of the worker. Industrial worker constitutes only a segment of the general population, and the factors that influence the health of the population also apply equally to industrial workers, that is housing, water, sewage and waste disposal, nutrition and education. A detailed consideration of these factors, in addition to these factors, the health of the industrial workers in a large measure will also be influenced by conditions prevailing in their workplace. One of the declared aims of occupational health is to provide a safe occupational environment in order to safeguard the health of the workers and to set up industrial production. Occupational health care is a preventive health care which is provided on the basis of the Occupational Health Care Act. The objective of health care is a healthy and safe working environment, a well-functioning working community, prevention of work-related diseases, as well as the maintenance of employees' working ability and functional capacity, and promotion of their health. Advantages of occupational health. Investigates and assess load factors and hazards and gives expert assistance for eliminating them, gives information and advice, estimates employees' working ability and monitors their health condition. By its knowledge and skill, supports actions for maintaining working ability in the development of individuals, working environment and working community, in this way also affecting productivity continued. Prevents occupational disease and other work-related illnesses, prevents premature incapacity for work, reduces pension costs, reduces absenteeism due to sickness, can make calculation of the profitability of occupational safety and health and occupational health care in cooperation with workplaces, or encourage workplaces to make these themselves. Occupational environment. By occupational environment is meant the sum of external conditions and influences which prevail at the place of work and which have bearing on the health of the working population. The industrial workers today is placed a highly complicated environment which is getting more complicated as men in becoming more ingenious. Basically, there are three types of interaction in a working environment. Man and physical, chemical and biological agents. 2. Man and machine. And 3. Man and man. Physical agent. The physical factors in the working environment which may be adverse to health are heat, cold, humidity, air movement, heat radiation, light, noise, vibrations and ionizing radiation. The factors act in different ways on the health and efficiency of the workers, singly or in different combination. The amount of working and breathing space, toilet, washing and bathing facilities are also important factors in an occupational environment. Chemical agents. These comprises a large number of chemicals, toxic dust and gases which are potential hazards to the health of the workers. Some chemical agents cause to disabling respiratory illnesses, some cause injury to skin, and some may have deleterious effects on the blood and other organs of the body. Biological agents. The workers may be exposed to viral, rickettsial, bacterial and parasitic agents, which may result from close contact with animals or other product, contaminated water, soil or food. Man and machine. An industry or factory implies the use of machines driven by power with emphasis on mass production. The unguarded machines protecting and moving parts, poor installation of the plant, lack of safety measures are the causes of accidents, which is a major problem in industries. Working for a long hours in unphysiological posture is the cause of fatigue, backache, disease of joints and muscles, and impairment of the works, health and efficiency. Men. There are numerous physical factors which operate at the place of work. These are the human relationships amongst workers themselves on the one hand and those in authority over them on the other. For example, psychosocial factors include the type and rhythm of work, work stability, service condition, job satisfaction, leadership style, security workers, participation, communication, system of payment, welfare condition, degree of responsibility, trade union activities, incentives, and a host of similar other factors. All entering the field of human relationships in modern occupational health, the emphasis is upon the people, the condition in which they live and work, their hopes and fears and their attitudes towards their job, their fellow workers and employees. The occupational environment of the workers cannot be considered apart from his domestic environment. Both are complementary for each other. The worker takes his worries home and brings to his work disturbances which arise in his domestic environment. Stress at work may disturb his sleep, just as stress at home may affect his work. Severe prolonged stress, no matter where it has been aroused, may produce seriously physical or mental symptoms which do not allow man to work efficiently. According to ecological approach, occupational health represents a dynamic equilibrium or adjustment between the industrial workers and his occupational environment. There is the undertaking for the need of occupational health services. Any undertaking which employ more than the prescribed number, public sector undertaking, atomic energy unit explosive, production unit mining unit, and asbestosis production unit, a unit where workers are exposed to health hazards from toxic substances. Functions of occupational health services: pre-employment medical examination, first aid emergency services, supervision of the work environment and the control of dangerous substances in the work environment. 4. Specific periodic medical examination, particularly for the workers in dangerous operations. 5. Health education for disseminating information on specific hazards and risks in the environment. 6. Special examination and surveillance of health of women and children. 7. Advising the employer or management of for improving working conditions and placement of hazards. 8. Monitoring of working environment and assessment and control of hazards. 9. Supervision over sanitation, hygiene and canteen facilities. 10. Liaison and cooperation with the safety committee. 11. Maintenance of medical records and medical checkup and follow-up for maintaining health standards and also for evaluation. 12. To carry out other parallel activities such as nutrition program, family planning, social services, recreation concerning the health and welfare of the worker. The factors for effectiveness of occupational health services: the nature of industry, small, medium or large in its location; 2, existing infrastructure of health services; 3, trained manpower; 4, workers' involvement and employees' commitment; 5, surveillance of the working environment by means of epidemiological studies and testing. Components of occupational health services: medical treatment, first aid treatment in emergency; 2, health education, first aid education; 3, medical examination; 4, pre-employment examination; 5, medical treatment; 6, periodical medical examination are divided into 3 parts: pre-employment examination, periodic medical examination and special medical examination; health counseling, stress management, mental health and physical health, rehabilitation program, medical rehabilitation, social rehabilitation, educational rehabilitation, vocational rehabilitation. Occupational disease: disease due to physical agents, disease due to chemical agents, disease due to biological agents, occupational cancers, occupational dermatitis, psychological problems. From these slides, we will discuss the occupational hazards first, then we will go to join this slide. Let me tell you about the occupational hazard, which is very, very important for you to know about it. Actually, occupational hazard is the industrial worker may be exposed to 5 types of hazards depending upon his occupation: physical hazard, chemical hazard, biological hazard, mechanical hazard and psychosocial hazard. These are agents or hazards. This is the same thing. Physical hazard, we will discuss about this. 1, physical hazard. Heat and cold. The common physical hazard in most industries is heat. The direct effect of heat exposure and burns, heat exhaustion, heat stroke and heat cramps. The direct effects are decreased efficiency, increased fatigue and enhanced accident risk. Many industries have local hotspots, oven and furnaces, which radiate heat. Radiant heat is the main problem in foundry, glass and steel industries, while heat stagnation is the principal problem in jute and cotton textile. High temperature are also found in mines, for instance in the Kolar gold mines, which is the second deepest mine of the world. Temperatures as high as 65 degrees centigrade are recorded. Physical work under such condition is very stressful and impairs the health and efficiency of the workers. For gainful work involving sustained and repeated effort, a reasonable temperature must be maintained in such or in each workroom. Important hazards associated with cold work are emergence foot and frostbite as a result of general hypothermia. 2, we have cold like light. We have second problem: the workers may be exposed to the risk of poor illumination or excessive brightness. The acute effect of poor illuminations are eye strain, headache, eye pain, congestion around the cornea and eye fatigue, the cornea. Chronic effects on health include minors. Exposure to excessive brightness or glare is associated with discomfort, annoyance and visual fatigue. Intense direct glare may also result in blurring of vision and lead to accidents. There should be sufficient and suitable lighting, natural or artificial, wherever persons are working. Third, we have noise. Noise is health hazard in many industries. The effect of noise are of two types: auditory effect, which consists of temporary or permanent hear loss. Number two, non-auditory effects, which consist of nervousness, fatigue, interference with communication by speech, decreased efficiency and annoyance. The degree of injury from exposure to noise depends upon a number of factors, such as intensity and frequency range, duration of exposure, and individual susceptibility. Radiation, ultraviolet radiation. Occupational exposure to ultraviolet radiation occurs mainly in arc welding. Such radiations mainly affect the eyes, causing intense conjunctivitis. Symptoms are redness of the eye and pain. These usually disappear in a few days with no permanent effect on the vision or on the deeper structure of the eyes. We have vibrations. Vibration, especially in the frequency range 10 to 500 hertz, may be encountered in work with pneumatic tools such as drills and hammers. Vibration usually affects the hands and arms. After some months or years of exposure, the fine blood vessels of the fingers may become increasingly sensitive to spam. Exposure to vibration may also produce injuries of the joints of the hand, elbows and shoulders. We have next problem. This is the ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation is finding increasing application in medicine and industries. For example, X-rays and radioactive isotopes. Important radioisotopes are cobalt-60 and phosphorus-32. Certain tissues such as bone marrow are more sensitive than others, and from a genetic standpoint, there are special hazards when the gonads are exposed. The radiation hazards comprise genetic changes, mal formation, cancer, leukemia, depletion, ulceration, sterility, and in extreme cases death. The International Commission of Radiological Protection has set the maximum permissible level of occupational exposure at 5 rem per year to the whole body. We have mechanical hazards. The mechanical hazards in industry center around machinery and moving parts and the like. About 10% of accidents in industries are said to be due to mechanical causes. We have another problem. This is a chemical hazards. Chemical hazard, there is hardly any industry which does not make use of chemicals. The chemical hazard are on the increase with the introduction of newer and complex chemicals. Chemicals agent act in three ways: local action, inhalation and ingestion. The ill effects produced depends upon the duration of exposure, the quantum of exposure and individual susceptibility. Local action. Some chemicals cause dermatitis, eczema, ulcer and even cancer. by primary irritant action, some cause dermatitis by an allergic action, some chemicals, particularly the aromatic nitro and amino compounds such as TNT and aniline, are absorbed through the skin and cause systematic effect. Occupational dermatitis is a big problem in industry. Second, inhalation. Number one, dust. Dust are finally divided into solid particles with size ranging 0.1 to 150 microns. They are released into atmosphere during crushing, grinding, abrading, loading and unloading operation. Dust are produced in a number of industries: mines, foundry, pottery, textile, wood or stone working industries. Dust particles larger than 10 microns settle down from the air rapidly, while the smaller ones remain suspended indefinitely. Particles smaller than 5 microns are directly inhaled into the lungs and are retained there. This fraction of the dust is called respirable dust and is mainly responsible for pneumonosis. Dust have been classified in inorganic and organic dust, soluble and insoluble dust. The inorganic dust are silica, mica, coal. The organic dusts are cotton, jute and the like. The soluble dust dissolves slowly, enter the systematic circulation and are eventually eliminated by good metabolism. The insoluble dust remain more or less permanently in the lungs. They are mainly the cause of pneumonosis. The most common dust diseases in this country are silicosis and arthrosis. 2. Gases. Exposure to gases is a common hazard in industry. Gases are sometimes classified as simple gases, oxygen and hydrogen. Acidifying gases, that's carbon monoxide, cyanide gas, sulfur dioxide, chlorine, and anesthetic gases, this is chloroform, ether. Carbon monoxide hazard is frequently reported in coal gases, manufacturing plant and steel industries. Third, we have metal and their compounds. A large number of metals and their compounds are used throughout the industry. The chief mode of entry of some of them is by inhalation as dust or fumes. The industrial physician should be aware of the toxic effects of lead, antimony, arsenic, cadmium, cobalt, manganese, mercury, phosphorus, chromium, zinc and others. The ill effect depends upon the duration of exposure and the dose or concentration of exposure. Unlike the pneumonosis, most chemical intoxication respond favorably to cessation exposure and medical treatment. Third, we have ingestion. Occupational disease may also result from ingestion of chemical substance such as lead, mercury, zinc, chromium, phosphorus, etc. Usually these substances are swallowed in minute amounts through contaminated hands, food or cigarettes. Much of the ingested material is excreted through feces and only a small proportion may reach the general blood circulation. Psychosocial hazard. The psychosocial hazards arises from the worker's failure to adapt to an aligned psychosocial environment. Frustration, lack of job satisfaction, insecurity, poor human relationships, emotion tensions are some of the psychosocial factors which may undermine both physical and mental health of the workers. The capacity to adapt to different working environment is influenced by many factors such as education, cultural background, family life, social habits, and what the work expects from employment. The health effects can be classified in two main categories: psychological and behavioral changes, including hostility, aggressiveness, anxiety, depression, tiredness, alcoholism, drug abuse, sickness, absenteeism. Psychosomatic ill health, including fatigue, headache, pain in the shoulder, neck and back, propensity to peptic ulcer, hypertension, heart disease, and rapid aging. Reports from various parts of the world indicate that physical factors, heat, noise, poor lighting, also play a major role in adding to the or precipitating mental disorders among the workers. The increasing stress on automation and electronic operations and nuclear energy may introduce newer psychosocial health problems in industry. Psychosocial hazards are therefore assuming more importance than physical or chemical hazard. Occupational diseases. There is no international accepted definition for the term occupational disease. However, occupational diseases are usually defined as disease arising out of or in the course of employment. For convenience, they may be grouped as under disease due to physical agent, this is a heat, cold, light and pressure, noise, radiation, mechanical factors, electricity, disease due to chemical agents, inorganic, dust, gases, organic, and metal and their compounds, chemicals, solvents, disease due to biological agents, occupational cancers, occupational dermatitis, disease of psychological origin. This is the role of health department in occupational safety and health. Periodic examination of workers and premises, mishap in investigation and reporting, personal protective equipment, agronomics program, medical surveillance program, and health education program. Periodic health checkup of workers, periodic examination of premises for danger assessment and recertification. Mishap investigation. Any mishap in industry premises must be investigated by occupational health specialist of health department. Analysis should be done for assessment of health mechanic. Errors and reports should be submitted accordingly. Personal protective equipment. Regular compliance with protective for personal equipment must be made a must for all industry. Regular warning must be issued for non-complying industries. Medical surveillance program. Industries must be regularly examined for workers' health, and industries with unsafe practices for tribal workers who can be danger to others must be notified by concerned industries. Health education program. Health education must be imparted to industry workers depending on the nature of the industry. It should be made mandatory for industries to employ full-time occupational health experts to impart health education to workers on continuous basis. Thank you.